Today we are going to talk about QuickTimer events. But what are they? For once, I will use the Wikipedia definition to help me. In video games, a QuickTimer event, or QTE, is a method of context-sensitive gameplay creation in which the player performs actions on the control device shortly after the appearance of an on-screen prompt. Okay, that's a mouthful. So, to put it simply, a QTE prompts the player to give a specific input within a time limit. It does so using a little GUI element that represents the required inputs. QuickTimer events allow for some limited control of the game during cutscenes. The main reason to use them is that they can improve the feel of an animation or a cinematic. They can give the player a fake sense of mastery of the scripted sequences, as you can see in AzRazRa, for example. Let me give you a little note about the name of this mechanic. Originally, it was called QuickTimer Event in Shenmue and not QuickTime Event. This makes sense, as a QTE is actually an event that revolves around a quick timer. Good QTEs can better the feel of cinematic moments in a game, but bad one will ruin your best shots. There are plenty of QTEs that break the player's immersion out there. In Battlefield 3, if you don't press a button at the right time, you can die because of a rat. You cannot just move past it or use your melee attack to slay it. You have to press the right button at the right time. The Order 1886, a game that's meant to offer mostly a cinematic experience, is filled with rhythm-breaking QTEs. Most of the time, when you are given a choice in a cinematic, it isn't really one. QTEs have no consequence beyond hurting the flow of the shots in that case. A bad QuickTimer event has straightforward characteristics. It happens either when the developers force a cinematic where the regular gameplay would work, or when they try to put gameplay in the middle of a scene that's not tense or epic and meaningful enough to justify the use of gameplay elements. In general, it is easier to analyze what we do wrong rather than what we do right in design. Strangely enough, I find that it works the other way around with QTEs. So what are the characteristics of a good QuickTimer event? Well, good QTEs are ones that work in synergy with your cinematic and your gameplay as well. They don't break the flow of the game, and in particular the emotion or expected rhythm of the cinematic phases. In a cinematic, each shot is meant to convey a certain meaning. It has a clear goal. If you pose it right in the middle, your shot will become meaningless. Second, good QTEs reinforce the current scene, both in terms of timing, but also as far as their GUI representation is concerned. The sound design and GUI animation of a QuickTimer event is critical. Let us take a look at some examples to see what works in practice. Be them all like God of War or Bayonetta give us examples of some of the most efficient QTE implementations you can have. They generally happen when the player is on the verge of killing a powerful enemy or a boss, which gives the player a sense of control over an already epic scene. QTEs work well with the hectic action of beat them all. God of War 3 is particularly interesting. Whenever Kratos is struggling, the player has to keep mashing one or two buttons quickly. Whenever the QTE corresponds to a series of unique moves, the buttons to press are placed along the edge of the screen, corresponding to the direction the hit is headed. You can see how the camera also follows the limbs of the character that are going to do the action, to add weight to each punch or kick. AzRazRa gives us another example of QTEs that intensify fights with a great percussive button mashing sound. I have to mention Heavy Rain, where the QTEs can, in a few instances, deeply affect the story. One of the main characters can die at times if you fail a QTE, and the story will still go on afterwards. Ace Combat: Assault Horizon has one QTE that is pretty famous. The player can press the triangle button to raise the fist of the character as a sign of victory. Note how, once again, the button the developers picked is the one at the top of the gamepad, which flows well with the upwards action. But as far as QuickTimer events are concerned, my heart goes all the way to Paper Mario 2. Pretty much each attack or skill you can use in that RPG revolves around one unique QTE. You have to study that game if you want to create QTEs that work. Each requested input follows the flow of the character's current action or anticipates the resulting move. Anyway, if you want to design good QTEs, I invite you to study how other games manage them. The way you are going to time them will highly depend on your game and the very moment you want to have a QTE. Okay, we are going to wrap up this video with a quick look at how QuickTimer events work on the technical side. The techniques used to code QTEs are present at the core of many common game mechanics, combos in particular. A game like Osu, the dialogue system of Alpha Protocol, as well as the contextual interactions of Paper Mario's battles are a few variations over the concept of QTE from a technical standpoint. On the programming side, a QuickTimer event works the same way combos do, although it's generally simpler. Here's how it works. First, we launch a timer. Second, if the player gives a specific input while the timer is running, he wins. If the timer ends, however, the player loses. It's that simple. Alright, so that's it for the basics of QuickTimer events from a design standpoint. Next week, I will show you how to code such a system using Construct 2. If you like the video, you can become a subscriber to get notified whenever I release a new video. And thank you for watching.